Good evening, Mr. Nye. My name is Loki Mudbogger, and I have cerebral palsy, so I'm sorry if I sound weird or look weird. But my question to you was on cold fusion. Was it something that actually had merit, or was it something that the scientific community legitimately had reasons for abandoning? Your thoughts, please.
Loki, don't look that weird to us, sir. You look fine. About cold fusion. So here was the idea. There's a guy who really had the first patent on television. Was the mythic, this was really his name, Philo Farnsworth. And it is said he told people that he had the idea for television by plowing his uncle's potato field as a kid. And he looked at the way the furrows went across the field and inferred that would be a way to make a moving picture. That same guy got it in his head that he could make neutrons do whatever he wanted. Like, he had this one success, and he got it in his head that he could influence neutrons, and he created a device which he called a phaser, and that word has later been used to describe rotating vectors in light waves and heat waves. But this thing was going to enable neutrons to fuse together at room temperature. He was not able to do it. I mean, this, in order to do that, as far as we can tell right now, you need the gravity of a star, which we have at our nearby star, the sun. And people have speculated that you could also contain fusion. Not speculated. That's an exaggeration. I'm shortchanging us. People have shown that you could contain fusion in a magnetic field, a very, very strong magnetic field. But no one has been able to build a magnetic field powered by the fusion reaction that the fusion reaction makes enough power to establish the magnetic field strong enough to hold it. So in my experience growing up, it's always 40 years from now when this will be done. But recently, an aircraft company, I guess it was McDonnell Douglas, claimed that they'd be able to make fusion happen at room temperature. I'm very skeptical because I look at what happens in nature with these stars. But it's so far, cold fusion was a myth. Now, then about 25 years ago, 1988, 1990, scientists at a university in the state of Utah here in the U.S. thought they had established cold fusion, that they had established a magnetic field powered by the energy of the fusion that would contain the reaction. But they didn't. They had the thermometer in the wrong place on their lab equipment. And I cite this as an example of journalists who were not scientifically literate enough to question this published result or announced result. And they just let the journalists let the thing spiral out of control to the point where somebody like you, 25 years later, is asking essentially the same question. Can we have fusion at room temperatures? As far as we know, no. However, it is reasonable that you will be alive when people really do figure it out. It's exciting. It's a great question.